snow's coming down. It's kind of in between snow and sleet, I guess. But I'm hiking out to the woods today, cook up a little lunch. Got me a strip steak and a potato. Think about mashed potatoes and steak on a cold day. Makes me smile. So that's what we're doing today. Guess the old Moore didn't like the knifey poke slam technique today, but still got some good material to work with here. Plus I got a backup knife out here. So let's keep on going. Doesn't have to be perfect, but yeah, just want to cut them up a little bit.
Listen to the sizzle, boar.
All right, so I've taken the steak off. You guys know me. I cook a steak perfect. This is medium well. Ah, potatoes probably could use another couple minutes, so as the steak rests, I'll keep heating the potatoes. This little frying pan, I'm about to use this as my plate. Don't think it's big enough for the steak, but I don't really have a good plate. I need to invest in like a nice little plate to bring out here. Something that's big. Big enough for these big steaks I cook. Also, it's gotta have a little lip on it so them juices don't be running out of there, boy. Also doubles as like a little fire fanner. You know what I mean? All right, for these mashed potatoes, I brought a little bit of the scallions out, a little green onion, and some butter to mix in with it. All right, these potatoes gotta be done. Done enough. All I'm gonna do is add butter, pour out the water, add the green onions. Just a simple mashed potato. Oops. You get back in there. Oh no! Dang it. Dang it. Oh well. Leave that for the squirrels. You can hear the wind starting to go. Already dumped my butter in. Green onions. Let's get to mashing. Probably should have brought a little milk or whatever you're supposed to add. Slipped my mind.
Give me some of that gravy, boy. Southern gravy.
All right, there she is, boys. Steak and potatoes. In a sleet storm. You hear it coming down? Coming down, all right. It's coming down. All right, time to eat. What do you guys think? I mean, it's got a little pink action, got a little char, a little pink action. I don't think you can do much better than that out in the woods. Ooh, a little potato on top. First bite, 10 out of 10.
Look at the protein. Look at the carbs, boy.
You can see the potatoes are a little dry, but like I said, I didn't bring any like cream out or milk, so that explains that. So the amount of firewood I gathered from this fire was absolutely perfect. It really doesn't take that much wood to cook a little meal out in the woods. A couple pieces, half size as my wrist, is all it took. cooked the potatoes, probably about 20 minutes, 15, 20 minutes. Steak was about 6-7 minutes a side. Only seasoned one side of the steak. The idea I had of cooking inside the shelter was a really good idea, actually. Last time I tried to cook out in the rain, it did not go like I wanted to. Good meal, solid. Steak, 9 out of 10, cooked pretty much perfectly. Mashed potatoes, they're good, 6.5. But you guys can see, it's coming down a little bit more now. I was thinking about doing some work on the camp today, but I messed my neck and my back up between last video and this video, so try not to do any heavy lifting or a lot of sawing and chopping and stuff like that. Try to keep it to a minimum, but hopefully within another week or so it's better and I can come out here, build up this back wall a little bit more. Looking pretty good. Start filling the gaps. I'm not sure what I'm gonna use. Mud mixed with something, perhaps. Redo the roof, do the sidewall. No, this idea about cooking in the shelter's got my little brain churning. It's got me thinking maybe I wanna incorporate a fire pit or like a little oven, chimney, stone fireplace, have it ventilate underneath or out the wall or something like that. I think that'd be pretty cool, but haven't made any decisions yet. Just kind of thinking out loud. It's really coming down now. There's just like little tiny snow particles. It's not like the big ones. Not like the big fluffy ones you catch on your tongue. But yeah, I got a little bit of nibble left on the steak left to eat. And that thing, I think that'll be about it for this meal. So hopefully next time you guys follow along, come back out here, do a little more work at the shelter. I've got to lash together all those little pieces, those little tiny pieces on my countertop. Like I mentioned, finish this wall, finish the sidewall, redo the roof. I think I'm going to actually put a couple pieces in to make the roof stick out a little further, a little more coverage from the rain. I got to make a firewood storage area, which I've been looking at all this wood that I've got. So let's rewind the tape a little bit, probably about a year ago at a nearby property that was actually doing some development, and I stopped, talked to them, and was able to get all of the cedar from their property. So I hauled it all out here. It took me a long time to get it back here. Now I've got good straight stuff that I can build this camp with. I'm pretty happy about. I don't know, but I've got a little bit more wood to use. So once I finish the shelter, I can expand into something useful, something practical, something I can actually use. Be cool to have another lean-to right there. Think that's about it, guys. Meal was good. Video was fun. Times were memorable. It's snowing big time now. All right, guys. I'm gonna hang out for a bit, finish my meal, clean up, hike up on out of here. If you're still watching, you like the video, hit subscribe, like the video, do all that, share it with your grandma, grandpa, friends, family, whatever. Till next time, Scrambled O, signing off.